your horse show for May 2011. Yes, I know this is being broadcast in June, and I know it's been a while. But as I explained at the end of my last show, I've been a bit busy. But don't worry, in this show I have 2 months worth of news to mock and joke about. Well, where do we start? The soap opera, that is the X Factor judging panel, continues to rage on, with Cheryl Cole's accent making her identifiable to the Americans as an alien from another planet, or to the rest of us, Ireland. US President Barack Obama recently completed a tour of the UK and the rest of Europe. During his visit, he destroyed a Cadillac, burned some burgers, and met the Queen. All the makings of a Hollywood blockbuster. And with deadly E. coli spreading across Europe, most of us are asking, what was wrong with McDonald's in the first place? Last 2 months is definitely the PlayStation Network hacking story, or, as it was called by the journalists, the ideal dream story. Because it made the kids look bad and the parents look bad at the same time. The major worry, of course, was that many people's personal details were stolen, which I think leaves an important message. Online gaming is a waste of time. This story also means that there is a new market for new PlayStation security adverts, like this one.
PlayStation, please, don't run the risk.
The other major historical entertainment story of the month was, of course, the royal wedding, which was watched by 2 billion people around the world. Here in Britain, 27 million people watched it on television, just over 20 million on BBC, and just over 6 million on ITV. Why the major difference in viewing numbers, I hear you ask? Well, there are 2 very good reasons why BBC did better than ITV. Well, firstly, ITV's Royal Wedding Studio was painted a sickening colour. And secondly, after the World Cup advert debacle, everyone in Britain knew that when Kate and William were about to kiss, ITV would cut to an advert of a Korean car. Typically, most of Britain were just waiting for something to go wrong. Unfortunately, the favourite, rain, didn't occur. But the fact that Kate's ring very nearly didn't fit on her finger did fill most of our expectations. Some of my other personal highlights from the royal wedding were the crowd who cheered everything from falling over a policeman to a road sweeper, Prince Harry looking and acting so ridiculously nervous, and of course, we all got a day off. Woo! Yeah, I really should stop this whole party popper thing. My only ever real disappointment was, despite the fact that for once the whole royal family was drunk, or probably anyway, we still don't know who Prince Harry's real father is. I might give a headshot off for that. Now, the show's been off the air. The major international political story was, of course, the finding and killing of Osama bin Laden. Yes, after many years of the USA and British soldiers searching through caves in the wrong country, it turns out, after all this time, he was living in a mansion in Pakistan. Right next to Pakistan's main military base. Which isn't at all suspicious in any possible circumstances. Lots of people don't think he's actually dead, and you can sort of see why, because no one actually saw him die, or his funeral. Because, like the royal wedding, his funeral could have been turned into a massive international television event. But no. Apparently he was buried at sea. His body was apparently dumped into the sea. But as yet, no video footage of this has emerged. The other major political news was, of course, all this strange business about super injunctions. Of course, the Conservative government loves them. Or rather, the Conservative Party loves them. I forgot about Nick Clegg there for a minute. Because all of them can actually afford a super injunction. Of course, we all know that there has been a footballer in the news a lot, especially about this whole super injunction nonsense. But this footballer is not allowed to be named in England. Even though you probably all know who it is anyway. But there is no law saying that I can't give you a few clues if you have no idea. So here is your clue. Fill out the blanks and have fun. I don't really know what all the fuss about? I mean, I have a super injunction. Oops. Someone get me a lawyer. I want to know if I can sue someone for me revealing that I have a super injunction. Oh. In an economic climate where everything is getting more and more expensive, you can see why this story made the headlines. Asda sold 12.9p petrol by mistake in Bradford. That's Asda price. This story is laughable. Firstly, on Asda's behalf for putting the wrong price into its computer system, and secondly, 50 people got an absolute bargain. Nothing is 12p anymore. Here is what Asda said about the incident. For a couple of hours, some lucky customers got some petrol at the wrong price at our Rooley Lane store. If you read between the lines in that statement, you can tell that people are going to lose their jobs over this. Dum dum dum! And now it's time for the Facebook break. And I actually have a red button this time. Look at this. Red button. Anyway, you have 20 seconds to update and check your Facebook status starting from now. Stories have appeared in the British media, so prepare for an extra long bizarre Britain section to this show. Let's start with this. Don't worry, viewers, your eyes do not need testing. That is indeed a man trying to board a train with a pony. Yes, this is the story of a man in Wrexham trying to board a train with his pony. He even tried to buy a ticket for the animal. Obviously, he was not allowed on board. But the reason the River Trains Wales gave was a bit strange. Large animals, including horses and ponies, which may pose a risk to the general public, are not permitted travel. Yes, a lion or a tiger maybe, but accusing a pony of being a dangerous animal, I think is a bit harsh. However, this is not the only thing the madman and his pony have tried to do. Apparently, he also took the pony into a pub, and then also took it into a hospital. The first thing I thought when I heard he tried to take the pony into a hospital was, how mad the Health and Safety Department and the cleaners would have gone. They probably went, right, we must decontaminate the entire hospital. No one was allowed. The NHS could do without problems such as foot and mouth and bird flu on their hands. They have enough problems already. Decontaminate the entire area, close the hospital. No one else is allowed in. I think I might be losing a bit, but you get the idea. They are going to have gone absolutely berserk. Speaking of strange animal stories, here's another one, but this time from Hampshire. Hampshire tiger sighting causes major alert! I bet some of you are now panicking, and I bet the rest of you are going, Springwatch is going to be very different from now on. Well, sorry to disappoint you all, but despite the use of armed policemen, helicopters, and thermal imaging cameras, it turned out to be a fake. It just turned out to be a stuffed animal. But for 20 minutes, it threw Hampshire into a scene of chaos from a disaster movie. A cricket game was suspended for 20 minutes, a golf course was evacuated, and even motorways were closed. Imagine how stupid everyone looked when it turned out to just be a cuddly toy. Speaking of animals and closing motorways, here is my final bizarre Britain story for this show. Cow strays onto Surrey stretch of the M25. Yes, Britain's favourite motorway, the M25, was closed for exactly 6 minutes while a cow was taken back to its farm after straying onto the motorway for a broken fence. Makes you proud to be British. But what would you say to your boss if you arrived late for work? Sorry, sir, there was a cow on the motorway. Sounds a bit unconvincing, doesn't it? Imagine what the radio traffic reports were like as well. We're getting reports of a cow on the M25. We're not sure if it's a practical joke or whether or not the cow is actually trying to escape to a better life. Now, at the end of each show, I'll give you a picture to look at, and you can post captions as comments on this video. I will judge which one is the best, and the winner will get a mention in my next show. So last month, I gave you all this picture to look at. So I can announce that the winner from last time's caption competition is Nick Westcott, with this caption. For this month, here is a recent news picture for you all to post captions to. So if you've never taken part in this show's caption competition, now is the time, as this will be the last one, because next show will be my last show for Pulse TV. And because it's my last show, it'll be a little different to what I usually do. Instead of mocking the news, I'll be looking back at my favourite moments from the last few years of me working on Pulse TV. Yes, the time has come for me to move on from Hagley and from Pulse TV. I will, of course, though, announce the winner of this month's caption competition, so don't worry about that. I can't give you a definite date yet when my last show will be uploaded to YouTube, but it will probably be in the last week of June. But keep an eye on the Pulse TV website for more news on that. We'll also post a date, of course, to the Pulse TV Facebook group. So don't miss it. Until then, this is Matthew Paul saying goodbye, viewers, and I'll see you all again soon for one last time.